Hey guys, it's Dark. So, I was feeling a little off tonight. I started to feel guilty about some stuff, and maybe this is like you. I felt like a lot of times I do some things. I kind of waste away some of the things that I'm supposed to do, you know, and I create a mess, and then I'm like, God, here's my mess, please do it. You know, like, and it's like, I know that I can do differently. I know that, you know, I can change some of the things that I am doing, and I just don't. And then I create a mess, and once I create a mess, I'm like, God, please save me from my own mess and my own making. And I feel like I do this so many times, and so, you know, and I feel guilty about it, and, you know, like, it changes maybe for a little bit, and then, boom, I'm right back at it again. Because I just kind of go back to my natural way of doing things. And I feel like this is something that a lot of us go through. And so I just wanted to share with you something. Habakkuk 2:2 says, write down the vision, make it plain, so that he who reads it can run diligently. And that's maybe a little paraphrasing there, but that's where it is. And I've just realized for myself, again and again and again, you know, like I run a race, but not diligently. And I do things, but not with the plainness that I should. And I've realized that organizing my life, sometimes that needs to be a priority. And I'm thinking about reorganizing my life and, you know, like some of the ways that things are, because I always have a lot going on, and we all do. And so maybe it's time for us to organize our life to the point where we can start to say, you know, like, God, it's not that I know that you're disappointed in me or that you won't save me, but I know that I can be better. I know that I can love you better with the things that I do. And so I just kind of encourage you as well, like, as I do this, I'm like, okay, I'm going to write down, you know, like, this is what it is that I'm going to do. And this is the way that, you know, like, I'm going to prioritize the things in my life. And as I start to do that, it's going to be plain to the one that reads it. And you know who's going to read it? Me. So, you know, like, things that are going on in life, I know, like, hey, look, this is the vision. This is what it's going, and this is what it's growing to. This is what I'm doing now. And whenever I see it, I know what I'm doing. And I know how to prioritize life. I know that I don't have to get myself into messes because I'm so preoccupied with everything over here and over here and over here. And I get, you know, like, nothing done because I'm so split. But whenever I center myself and whenever I get to this vision, then all of a sudden I can run diligently and I can make it plain. And then there's no confusion. Because, you know, where the confusion is where the enemy loves to play. And so I just encourage you, all the things that God is calling you to do, all the things that you know you're supposed to do, prioritize, write it down, make it plain. Don't let there be any confusion, because that's going to help you grow closer to God. In the end, we can always say, well, I'm going to put God first. Well, and I've mentioned this in another video, God doesn't want to be first. He wants to be center. And so whenever we make these things plain, it's not, hey, I'm going to, you know, this or whatever. It's, hey, look, these are the things that I know I'm supposed to do, and they're in the order that I know God has shared with me. First and foremost, I'm a husband and I'm a father. How do I make sure, like, what is the goals? What is the vision for that right now? And then building off of that, you know, and making sure that I'm giving my whole heart to the things that matter and not giving it to random things along the way, being diligent about my heart. So hopefully that touches you. It's just something that I feel like I had to go on a walk to talk to God about in the middle of the night. So, yeah. Thanks for taking a minute.